Good evening. My name is Miika Kurkela, and this is an Android smartphone. Today we will start from zero knowledge, and then after about 10 minutes we will end up with writing our own applications into these smartphones.
So, we need a computer with a so-called Android Studio software development tool. In the first half of this video, I show you step by step how to install that tool into your computer. Then I'll show you how to make with that Android Studio development tool this simple app and how to make it run into your smartphone. Finally, I'll show you as an example a more sophisticated one application where the smartphone takes a Bluetooth connection to this wireless thermometer, receives from it some temperature measurement values, and shows those values at your smartphone's screen. So, we start with the Android Studio tool. From here, you can get it for free. I will explain everything step by step. Here, just click that green download button. Most of the information here applies to all major operating systems. As an example, I will be using here a Windows 10 computer. Agree the license agreement by checking this small box so that that gray button changes its color to blue. Click that blue download button. At some Windows 10 computers, the user has to confirm the above choice by additionally clicking a Keep button. The size of that download file is about 700 megabytes, and from the lower left corner of the window, you'll see an estimation on how long does it take to download such a file. When the file is fully downloaded, right-click it and choose to open and to run that .exe file. You may need to confirm your data choice by answering yes to a pop-up window. At this welcome page, we are recommended to close all the other applications of our computer. Anyhow, it seemed to be totally safe to continue watching this YouTube video while installing the Android Studio. So just continue here by clicking the next button. You probably should keep all these default settings. But my, this laptop computer has only 4 gigabytes of RAM memory. That's why I don't install this Android virtual device. But if your computer has an Intel processor and about 6 gigabytes of RAM memory, you can safely choose to get that Android emulator into your computer already at this point. After these decisions, click the next button. This intended hard disk location for the installation is okay for me, so I click here this next button. I don't need any shortcut icon of the Android Studio program onto my computer's desktop, so I just click this install button. When that part of the installation is done, click this next button and start the Android Studio program by clicking this finish button. And here we just click the OK button, as we don't have any old settings that we would like to import from some previous versions of this same program. At this Setup Wizard Welcome window, just click that Next button. Accept the usage of standard settings by hitting also here the Next button. That user interface on the left will do for us, so we just hit the next button here too. Here, that folder name, Miika Kurkela, of the proposed Android Software Kit's location path contains a problematic space character. That's why I am asked to choose some other path for my Android SDK location. I decided to use a PathC Android SDK that doesn't include any such problematic characters. Make notice to the calculated total download size, which is clearly bigger than the .exe file that we downloaded a while ago. So, our next download process is going to take a respectively longer time. Now hit the next button here. This here is merely a list of all the files that we are about to download. Just hit that finish button. So, we know that the total size of the files to be downloaded here is 2 or 3 times the size of the .exe file that we downloaded in the beginning of this video. That information helps us to estimate how much time this current download process is going to take. When that download process is finally ready, hit this finish button. And now we get into the business. Click here that first option to start a new Android Studio project. You probably want to change that suggested application name to a more understandable one. Today, for instance, to Hello World or to Hello YouTube. For the next text field, there is no hurry to take action. Change that option later if you someday want to start publishing your own application. But today you may leave that strange domain name as it is. And again, there seems to be a space character in that Miika Kurkela folder name. That's why I have to choose some other path for my project location, so that the path doesn't include any such problematic characters. For instance, this C Android Android Studio projects will do. Finally, hit the next button of this pop-up window. Leave here the pre-selected phone and tablet and API 15 options as they are. Don't choose those other options yet, just hit the next button. In the following window, we are asked to choose a template onto which to build our application. That empty activity template is the Hello World application of the Android Studio. Let's choose it and then hit the next button. Here, leave the default values as they are and just hit the next button. In the following window, just hit that finish button. For my computer, this build process took about 2.5 minutes. At this point, the firewall of your computer may ask you to allow the usage of a Java Development Kit program. We are going to need that tool, so hit here the Allow button. By closing the appearing Tip of the Day pop-up window, you will at last get to the actual Development Environment tool. Wait a moment so that the Android Studio figures out what additional features it needs for our today's project. Those needed additional features will be shown at the lower half of the screen. Click the appearing blue links to download those additional tools. You may need to accept some license agreements to click some Next and Finish button and to repeat the process for some other blue links as I do here. When all the blue links are done and these running processes are finished, you will finally see here a message, Gradle build finished. Now, at the left side of the window, we have a file browser where that app folder contains all the needed files of our Hello World application. For starters, double-click that app folder, double-click the appearing res folder, and double-click the appearing layout folder too. That manifests folder is, among other things, containing the name of our new application and the permissions that are needed for running your application. And if your application needs to accomplish some tasks for you, then that Java folder would contain the actual Java programming language code of those tasks. The res folder contains some resources, such as user interface definitions, string values, menus, image files, and graphical layouts. By double-clicking that ActivityMain.xml file, you'll see one such graphical layout. Select here this text tab and you'll see the actual XML text of that file. And more importantly, you see the graphical layout that it defines. These layouts are easy to modify if you know how to write directly some XML code. And they are even easier to modify if you don't know anything about XML. Just drag that gray Hello World text from the center of the layout to a place where you want it to be, and see how the corresponding part of the XML text gets updated automatically. At this Design tab, you can easily, for instance, change the font size of our text. To upload this simple application into your real Android phone device, you must first check if it already is at its programming mode. So, navigate to the settings of your phone. If needed, switch from the general settings to all settings. If you find a row named Developer Options, your smartphone is very easy to be put into its programming mode. But if you don't find the Developer Options line, you anyhow will find an About Device or an About Phone line. Choose that line, and at that group of settings, you'll find a row that is telling you the build number of your device. Hit that build number row 7 times. You may need to confirm here that you indeed want to see those developer options. And now the needed developer options are accessible for all of us. Now navigate back to the previous level. There you will now find the developer options row. Hit that row, and in the next screen, you will find a row named USB debugging. Turn that feature on, and again, you may need to confirm that that is exactly what you want to do. Now, connect your phone to your computer with a USB cable, and our smartphone is ready to receive our first own application. To send the Hello World application to the smartphone, click at your computer's Android Studio this green triangle. At computer's next pop-up window, you should see some connected device. If your smartphone is asking one more time you to allow USB debugging, answer yes to that question too. And now you should see at your computer the connected smartphone's name in readable text. So choose the row of your smartphone and hit the OK button. And after a while, you see a new app icon being added into your smartphone. And right after that, our Hello World application starts running automatically. And now you may congratulate yourself. The words Hello World appear onto your smartphone screen. Our first smartphone application seemed to be a success, and we may close that project. And now, do start experimenting, for instance, with these example programs that are listed in here. I, for instance, was very eager to test the Bluetooth low energy feature that these smartphones have. So I chose this example program and modified it a little so that now I can see at my smartphone's screen the temperature measurement values that are broadcasted from this wireless thermometer.
In the description of this video, you will find a tutorial on how to make these Bluetooth low energy applications for your own smartphone. At the internet, there is a marvelous worldwide community where people that make applications discuss and share their knowledge. So, just search with Google at any given time for the information that you need and do start creating your own applications. So, take care and do start experimenting with these fascinating telephones. Goodbye.